Let's come now into our inner world, into our cosmic heartbeat within each of us. The breath, breathing in and out. And coming into the Om together. My voice has dropped into a bit of a croak. It's 7 a.m. where I am. So I've got my early morning voice on. So wherever you are in the world, joining me with the Om. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Guruve Namah. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Guruve Namah. With great respect and love, I follow my heart, my inner teacher. With great respect and love, I follow my heart, my inner teacher. With great respect and love, I follow my heart, my inner teacher. Namaste. Satguruna Maharaj Mata Ki Jai, Jagadambi Mata Ki Jai Jai Ma, Bhadrakali Mata Ki Jai, Durgakali Mata Ki Jai, Jai Ma, Jai Ma. So I invoke the life force power of the universe. Father of our souls, the source of all that is, I invoke the divine feminine, the divine mother, the mystery of that which lies behind the veil. As we breathe together, invoking the cosmic Christ consciousness, I call upon the goddesses Kali, Parvati, Juno, Vesta, Lilith, Pallas Athene. I call on Zeus, who is Jupiter. I call on Lord Saturn. I call on Chiron, for indeed all are involved, and so many more with what is occurring now on this earth plane, along with humanity, the collective. I invoke the Christ consciousness. our tubes of light, our chakra columns, the shashuma, dropping in now, letting go of the outer world, simply hearing my voice and following my prompting as you breathe in and out, anchoring deeply now through the base chakra, anchoring into the core of the earth, following the breath. Through the core of the earth, walking towards the inner chamber, and there is an obelisk, an enormous crystalline body that stands before us at the center of a pool of liquid love, the mother's waters, a spiritual spa of sorts, and we are all at the edge. And so we can either sit at the edge with your feet in, or you can walk down into the pool and dive right in. And breathing, allowing yourself to become fluid, to merge with these waters of liquid love, merging with the mystery. As you breathe in and out, and these waters carry a salty texture, and there is a density to it, holding you to enable you to float. And if you also are needing a chaise lounge, there is a chaise lounge there for you to fall into. To lie upon, to hold you. For indeed it is the Divine Mother holding you throughout this meditation. Already the pores of your skin have opened organically and osmotically. The waters of the Divine Mother are moving through your body, moving into your blood system with each breath that you take. In and out, moving into your nervous system, soothing and calming. Merging into your emotional body, your mental body, dissolving any thoughts about what you are capable of or what you're not capable of, dissolving you further into the arms of the Mother. And there is a shimmering of a misting from this enormous crystal, feeding you on a deeply soul level, feeding you not only throughout this meditation, but ongoingly. And there is gathering, more and more adjoining. There is much, and there is great support. There is support from the divine masculine, indeed as there is support from the divine feminine. Breathe it in, emboldening you to find your own source of your masculine, even as the divine cosmic Christ is right there next to you, assisting your divine flame to burn. Check now the divine love flame, the divine wisdom flame, and the divine flame of power, your power. Breathing with it. It is your own flame merged with the cosmic Christ that assists the collective at this time. Yes, you play a great part. The cosmic Christ, along with Lord Buddha, Lord Sananda, are at our backs, assisting all of us to find our inner strength, to connect into the Father of your soul on deeper and deeper levels. All the goddesses are around us, Durga too, Kali, the animal kingdom is present. From the greatest of predators down to the tiniest, the mice, together with the insect kingdoms. We are merging with all as we breathe, and we all sit in unison, in embracement of each one's unique, distinct differences. And there is a fluttering of all beings' energies. And it can be felt almost as an electrical ripple. It's more subtle than that, but there is a current, shall we say, felt within the cells, resonating throughout the cosmos. Feel that current. As you breathe, and there is a call from the animal kingdom. They look to us, for indeed, their kingdom is part of our foundation. Along with the mineral kingdom, we are all in it together. And all are going deeper within. Our way through is with the heartbeat. So, feeling the inner heart chamber now. The Divine Mother is beating within each of our heartbeats. Her beat is assisting us now to be transported deep within the esoteric heart, in the esoteric body, and it is here that we find ourselves surrounded by the goddesses. Not just in the grand cross configuration, but there is an entire circle of many, many, many goddesses, angels, breathing and beating with us. There is an entire support system that can be only found deep within the heart. And the still mind. So as we breathe, allowing yourself to become deeply fluid, and we are being escorted, each one of us as a group, but also individually, we each have three or four goddesses. Some of us are needing Kali, some of us needing Vesta. Vesta supports the sacred flame in the heart, the threefold flame. Kali, we know Kali. She helps us to eradicate, quite literally, our obstacles. Parvati assists us to be so focused, so still, so perhaps you might like to choose a quality that you would like to hone on a deeper level. feel the support come through the back of the heart. There is no skin boundary. They have begun their effusement, entrainment into our bodies and systems in totality, individually and as a group. And for some, you are floating. Others, you are on your back on the chaise lounge in the waters. But for each, there is a far-reaching healing. Accessing your encodements, allow your cells to flush now, literally standing out of the way as these ones who know and see all assist us. As we breathe, Christ consciousness, that which Lord Jesus, Lord Buddha, Yogananda tapped into, stands at the very center of each of our threefold flames. He is the core. And he is expanding from the inside out within each of us. Feel the internal walls of your heart be filled with a greater sense of the Christ consciousness. Also, this expansion is moving through our perceptions, moving through the third eye, spiritual sight, spiritual hearing. So that we each have a finer tuned antennae to pick up more subtle nuances throughout our day-to-day lives. There is an installation of sorts going on. have this finer attunement. Moving literally now from the center of the eyes to the sides and the backs of the eye socket, the eyeball, the fluid in the eyes. So that we may have a greater depth of sight, we will need it. What is coming I'm being told to say it is intense, if it's not already intense. We need to harness ourselves, strap ourselves in. And be very close to the cosmic Christ consciousness. So there is an unfoldment at the heart level, coming to a full standing posture within the Shushuma. Marrying up the third eye to be in greater communication with the heart, so that the sensory body will feel at deeper levels. Now allow that to flow through. It's anchoring deeply into the heart and moving down the third, second, and first chakra. Allow it to fall through your legs and your feet. There is a warmth to it. And I'm being told now, this is a different kind of a meditation, it's a bit of a channeling too, to not be afraid. There will be some alarming occurrences happening, to stay deeply entrenched within. And in doing so, there is a divine safety and a guidance system fully available to you. For those who trust and believe, there is an anchoring now, an activation on the left side of the heart. And she is Isis. Very close to Kali's frequency. She is anchoring into the second chakra. begin a tantric play, shall we call it, with Kali, with Isis, one and the same. She will sit in front of you. And heart to heart, there is a connection now. And she invites you to give unto her any aspect that is conscious and also unconscious that you know needs to be done, finished, released, forgiven, let go of. Just allow, be it emotions, thoughts, a layer of a whole experience, whatever it might be, allow it to flow through the frequency connection. Perhaps it can look like a laser beam. Your heart to her heart. Allow it to flow through you now. Give it to her. Unload. We need to be empty. We need to be the peaceful shore in this chaotic, mad, mad world. The world is not anchored any longer. Only you can be deep within. Anchor now. Give everything to the Divine One in front of you. Perhaps you have questions now. Perhaps you have some anxiety about what the future holds, which direction you need to go. Give it all. Perhaps it's just in a feeling. It doesn't have to be in a paragraph of words. Give a body of emotion that describes how you feel. Give it to the mother of your soul. She may not answer immediately, but she will answer. To those who sit patiently, quietly, it is the only way through the storm that indeed is occurring now. So anchor deeper into the heart now. Literally straight through the center of your shishuma, straight down into the core of the earth. If you need to conjure up a titanic anchor to hold you, do that. S- so that you have a home base always there. Now coming back up the Sushumna. Into the heart. Sitting with the Christ consciousness, with the goddesses. And we invoke the life force power of the universe. Source of all that is. And feel the ripple effect throughout all your bodies and systems. As you breathe. We have access to tremendous beings around the earth. The earth is the focal point of the entire cosmos now. There are beautiful space beings. Our Pleiadian sisters, and yes, the Lion's Gate is opening, and there is a roar, and at the moment, we are within, inside the roar. The roar is around us. Use the harmonics of this roar. You are being activated and propelled through the cosmos as we hurtle ahead in our linear time. And yet there is a dimensional shift occurring. And the answer is always to stay within. In the heart. Don't touch the electric fence. It's a gentle tiptoeing through the internal hallways that Source has provided for us, escorted by these beautiful beings of light, always at the ready to help us. Their help is found. Feel it now, deep within the no thing. is quiet, it is still. We are being lifted from the heart chakra through our chakra columns effortlessly upwards. Allow yourself to be drawn through that which is being released. It's almost as if layers of clothing are being left in the 3D as we are rising into the higher realms. Through the seventh chakra, eighth chakra, moving upwards into the ninth, tenth, beyond the Earth's atmosphere. We are sealed, protected, and held. And we are being bathed in a harmonic frequency that will assist us on an ongoing day-to-day basis to remember, to know, to see, and to feel. Lord Jesus Christ is right next to you. He emanates an extraordinary love. As he fills the harmonics with his heart's knowing of what will be over the next coming years. He wants us to know, to trust, and to believe that he will always be there. For indeed, the age we are moving into is built upon and because of the Piscean Age. As we breathe, we are being asked now to allow the breaking up of who we have thought we are, what we think we can handle, and to allow the more to move into our beings. We are so much more. There are waves and waves of harmonics rolling through us. Caressing our blueprint. Caressing each and every cell within all our bodies and systems. There's a rising within your Shishuma now of a greater embodiment of yourself. Your guides your third eye is activating. Expanding, so that you can take on this interbeingness that you are. A stretching within the hearing faculty. Shall we call it, they're dropping in the words, a spiritual sound bite. So that you will hear on greater levels your guidance. There is such affection, such endearment flowing through for you. You are so, so loved. You are adored. asking over and over to realize our greatness. For it is only this greatness that will assist in our survival from now on. So they want us to live it, to be it, to show it, and to shine. This is the message of the Lion's Gateway. From the Syrians this year. This is the year to grok deeply within your DNA so that you come alive fully. You awaken to your majesty. Your community needs you. So allow your heart to vibrate, resonate with the emanations that are moving through. Receive. And coming back down, even as we are, yes, in the heart, an aspect of our beings is in the 10th dimension. Coming back down the Sushumna column, the chakra column. Coming back down into the body and anchoring through the entire body system and deeply into the core of the earth. And with reverence, for your ability to connect, to be at one with the source of all there is, at one with Isis and Kali, the goddesses, the Christ consciousness. Bowing your head unto yourself, to the mystery as to how this quantum field communicates, resonates, and assists us all to feel this connection, to know that it is right there in every moment. giving thanks. And I will leave you here, and we will gather again. A Virgo new moon. And things will be a bit long when we get there. So anchor, connect, remember that you are the magnificent, extraordinary one. That is your answer. I am grateful for your presence, and I wish you well.